Bill Nye.
My name is Lauren Henley. I'm from Tennessee. And first off, I'd like to say that you're my favorite person ever in the world. But my question is, do you think we can build our own modern-day Frankenstein, you know, like sewing together body parts and somehow reanimating it? Do you think that's possible? Because you seem like the person to ask this. But anyway, thank you so much. I hope to see you on Big Tink.
Lauren, reanimating people from different body parts? Probably not, but something even more amazing is about to happen in biology and genetics. One point of clarification. Dr. Frankenstein created what came to be called Frankenstein's monster. The monster himself was not really called Frankenstein. Just a little science fiction point of interest there. So what will probably happen in your lifetime, just judging how old you appear on Big Think, is people like you will be able to regenerate parts of your body using your own cells that technologists in medicine and genetics are finding ways to get your own body to create more cells that it didn't used to be able to create. Like if you need a new pancreas, you'll be able to grow your own pancreas. And I don't know about complex mechanical systems like hands and fingers, but it doesn't seem beyond the technology that's being developed right now. Because in my lifetime, people came to appreciate the significance of stem cells. These are cells that have plenipotential. They can be anything. When you're a blastocyst, before you take on the form of a human or what have you. So the acronym is CRISPR, and I know the P there is palindromic, which is the same at both ends, the same backwards and forwards. And so people geneticists are finding ways to get cells to do whatever they want them to do. And it's presumed that instead of making a monster akin to Dr. Frankenstein's fictional creature by assembling pieces from disparate other humans, instead you'd get each person's own cells to create, regenerate body parts, or maybe in the womb, create extraordinary people that with extraordinarily smart, with extraordinary skills at dunking basketballs or what have you. But the idea of taking your consciousness and putting it in another device or another system or another biological system, is something that's been around for a long time. Science fiction has got it for a long time. And I'm always charmed by the singularity. When when computers are going to be as complex and sophisticated as a human brain, and that this moment in history is called the singularity, and then you'll just download all of your memories and all of your experiences into this presumed electronic storage system, and then you would live as long as you're plugged in, as long as you have electricity, what have you. It just seems way more complicated than that, and not something I would ever count on. And I don't think you can really be a whole person in the way you seem to be here on camera without your senses, without your eyes, ears, nose, and so on, feeling the world around you, your so-called central nervous system, which is part of your brain. I don't think it's that simple to put a brain in another body and carry on, or put your consciousness in an electrical receptacle and carry on. But you may be living at a time when extraordinary things will be done with your own cells that will far surpass anything that Dr. Frankenstein in the story was able to do. It's exciting. Carry on.